What's good, you guys? Okay, so I'm getting myself prepared to add some extensions into my hair. As I stated in the introduction, I'm going to be bonding my hair into my hair, my tracks into my hair. I shampoo and I condition my hair. This is the way that I do my deep conditioning. So I use the Silk Elements Mega Silk Conditioner, Deep Conditioning Mayonnaise. And I applied some of this Silk Remedy. It's the generic brand of the Chi Silk Infusion. And when I say that this stuff is like hair crack, it's hair crack. Because once you put this on your hair, it's going to be like, oh my God. Your hair is going to be like, give it to me and give it to me now. Because this stuff is like really, really good. I put this on my hair while it was damp. I let my hair air dry. And then I put some of the Silk Infusion oil application on my hair. And my hair is really, really soft. And then I blow dried it with my blow dryer and blow dry comb. So the look that I'm going for is some swoop bangs and some long curls and waves. What you'll need, of course, is comb, butterfly clips, or duckbill metal clips. This clips right here. Hair glue. And I purchased some human hair. It's the InStyle Micro Perm Yaki. And a 16 inch and a 14 inch. I got 16 inch for the length and 14 inch just so it could give my hair some layers, because I'm not going to cut it into layers because I don't want to risk trying to jack up my progress. So that's what we're gonna do. So what you're gonna do, I'm gonna start with my 16 inch here. Oh, and of course you're gonna need some scissors. Get this stuff out of the pack. And this is some really good human hair. Less than $30 a pack. It doesn't tangle, it doesn't shed. And when I say that this is some good quality, cheap human hair, it is. Look at that. It's just pretty. It's pretty, it's thick, it's full. I know it's kind of hot outside. And, you know, that's all really good. The way I'm going to position these tracks in my hair, I'm going to have it to where I can get my hair up into a ponytail. I'm not going to put the tracks really low to the nape of my neck. My hair is going to be blended throughout this process. So what I'm going to do, I have this mirror up here on the door, and it's gonna help me make a clean part. Okay, so far I have put only two pieces of hair in my, you know, in my head. And because I'm getting closer to the front up here, my sleep bang is gonna be on this side, as always. I want to make sure that I'm not gonna measure to have a lot of this piece of the hair track on this side, because I'm gonna have to put some pieces in my bang, because you know I cut my bang, so I'm gonna have to leave room so I don't overlap my tracks or it get too complicated for me to place or position the hair like it needs to be positioned in my bangs, if that makes sense. Another thing, even though I'm measuring, when I measure my hair track to fit in my part, I'm not bringing my track all the way to the edge. You want to leave some hair out on your edges just like you would a sewing, so you can cover it up and brush it back and it won't be difficult to pull the hair back. So I'm measuring about a fourth of an inch to, well, more like a half an inch in the part, and then starting to go around. So I have hair left out on the edges, so when I want to push it back or put it up in a ponytail, it's not difficult for me to do.